10 things I love about living in Czechia. I'm Katrina Zurich, an American living in České Budějovice, Czech Republic, and you're watching Checking with Katrina. Number one, I absolutely love that people in this country are very active. There's always so much to do here. It's winter. I mean, it is a nice day. It's about 50 degrees outside, so it's a beautiful day. But still, it's winter and the town is buzzing, filled with people everywhere. And it's like that even when it's freezing cold. There's always people everywhere doing something. Czech people are active. They're either skiing or sledding or going on hikes. Even in the little village that we live in, outside Budějovice, they're always taking their children or their dogs for a walk. People are very active regardless of the weather. You will even see them standing out in the cold, drinking svazhák around a table to visit. Not now because it's COVID, so there's a lockdown in this country, but when there's not a lockdown, all the restaurants still have outdoor tables all winter long. They have the heaters and people eat and drink outside in the winter. So I love that about Czech Republic, that people are so very active. In America, we are always inside. We park as close as we can to any building we're going into, whether it be shopping, a restaurant, whatever. And we walk from our car to the place we're going and then back to our car. That's about the only outdoors most Americans get, unless we plan a ski trip or something. But on a daily basis, not much. As you can see, I'm filming this video outside. I am in Budějovice. This is the Náměstí, the city square. Right behind me is the fountain. I will try to move the camera a bit and show you the beautiful fountain here, that beautiful building behind me. And just on the other side of this camera is the beautiful Black Tower, which one of these days I'm gonna go up to the Black Tower and show you what it looks like from there. But probably not today, because I only paid for 2 hours parking. So let's move on. Number two, the hospitality of Czech people. So when you're in a store or on the street, you don't really talk to strangers much in this country. Czech people keep to themselves, they don't talk to strangers. But when you meet somebody, you know them through a friend or family member, a friend knows them, and you go to their house, they are so hospitable. They make you feel so much at home. They immediately say, come in, sit down. They offer you slippers, because you have to take your shoes off in this country. It's just the thing. But they offer you slippers. They have you sit down. They bring you tea. They ask you if you want something to drink, tea or coffee or wine or beer. They're always offering you something to drink. And so then after they fix your drink, then they put something out. Always, always put out some kind of, it's either cookies or cake or cheese and salami or potato chips, something. They don't even ask you. They just set it down in front of you in case you want to eat it. And you don't have to eat it. You can just completely ignore it and it doesn't matter. They don't get offended. They just set it there because it's the hospitable thing to do. Number three, there is beauty everywhere in this country. As you can see, this beautiful fountain right behind me, the beautiful buildings all around the city center. Let me just move the camera a bit, just kind of turn it around, show you the beautiful buildings. So there's beautiful buildings everywhere you look. Even in the countryside, the rolling hills, they're absolutely gorgeous. This country is just beautiful. Buildings have statues all over them. It's just an absolutely beautiful country to visit and to live in. There's just beauty everywhere you look. Which brings me to number four, the castles. There are over 2,000 castles in this country. There are so many beautiful castles, and I love historical, gorgeous buildings. And so you really never get bored. If you want something to do, there's always something to do. You can just go drive. I don't know, sometimes it's like a half hour, maybe somewhere else in the country. For me, there's like two castles. One's like a 20-minute drive, the other's like a 15-minute drive. Here in Budějovice, you got Krumlov and Hulvoka. For other people, I don't know. There's got to be a castle within an hour from them. So there's always a beautiful castle that you can go walk around and enjoy. They all have beautiful gardens. I love the castles about this country. Number five, the prices. Yes, everything in this country for most Americans is extremely cheap. Scratch, reverse, Not everything. Some things are going to be more expensive in this country because they have higher taxes than we do and they pay an import tax. So we can get things a lot cheaper, especially electronics, clothes, things made in China, anything like that we can get cheaper in America. But here in Czechia, you can get a cart stocked full of groceries, and in the States you might be walking out spending $200, and here you're spending like $40. It's not cheaper really for Czechs because the wages here in Czechia are a lot less, which is a lot of the reason why our stuff is cheaper. Like at the grocery store, our groceries are cheaper because they're not paying as much for the checkout clerk as we would be paying in the States. Which brings me to number 6. Eating out. Right now with COVID, there's a countrywide lockdown, so we're not allowed to go out to eat. You can purchase stuff to go, but it's not the same. Eating out in Czechia is so fun because you go with friends and you sit and visit just like you would in the States. You go hang out with friends, you have a couple glasses of wine, you have some food. But in the States, usually the next day you have buyer's remorse. In other words, you look at what you ended up spending, and just to go hang out with a couple girlfriends and have a couple glasses of wine, maybe you'd have a salad or hors d'oeuvres because you're trying to keep things a little cheaper. Here, you just keep eating and eating, and by the time you're done, you may have spent $10 or $15. In the States, you've spent like $40 or $50. So I love being able to eat out here. Not that I really have any friends yet because I don't speak the language. I mean, I have a couple friends. They don't live in Budějovice. One lives north of Prague, so that's like a 3-hour drive from here. The other one, she lives like 45 minutes from here. So I don't really get together with girlfriends yet and eat out, but I am learning the language. So one day I'll be able to enjoy eating out with friends. As of now, I go with my husband and all of his friends, and I still kind of enjoy it. It's still nice to be out of the house and enjoy some food and some drink and without breaking the bank. Number 7, public transportation. I don't drive in this country. So what I love about this country is that there's so much public transportation. So buses go to and from almost every little village outside of Budějovice. So in the States, there might be some public transportation in big cities, but it's only like within the city. So like Chicago and then New York, like some metros and stuff. But here, there's like this bus system that just goes pretty much everywhere. I mean, if you want to get around in this country, you really don't need to own a car. We do own a car because my husband drives, but you don't need to own a car in this country, and you can pretty much get around almost anywhere if you're willing to walk to and from a bus stop. And if you want to watch a video where it's kind of a horror story of me getting stuck on a bus and not being able to get off almost, click here. You can watch this video right here. Number 8. Chleba. The bread in this country is absolutely amazing. There's tons of it. It's made fresh daily, all different kinds, and extremely cheap. I mean, you can get a loaf of bread. Now, I'm not talking white Wonder bread for 99 cents. No, I'm talking a delicious loaf of bread that you would have to go to Panera for, and you might buy it at Panera Bread for like $7. Here it's literally like a dollar, maybe a dollar and 10 cents. And it's so delicious. I have a video. I mean, it's amazing. You're not gonna believe how much bread they sell in this country, how much they make every single day. If you don't believe me, watch this video here called Bread, Bread, and More Bread, and it's amazing. It'll blow your mind, and it's delicious. Number 9, travel. There are so many places to travel. I mean, you're in the middle of Europe. You're in Central Europe. So literally, you jump in a car, and maybe for us, it was like 7 hours, and we were in Venice. Like, we spent the weekend in Venice because we jumped in the car and drove there. We drove to Budapest, we drove to Eger, which is, if you've never heard of it, it's this wine country in Hungary. It's awesome. Go to Eger. I totally recommend it. Absolutely beautiful. So you can drive there. We drive to Slovakia. You can drive to Austria. You drive to Germany. We're 4 hours. We're in Vienna. I mean, it's just, you can go so many places. And not just that, you jump on a plane and you can go, like, we go to Israel from here like twice a year. Not now because it's COVID and lockdown. It's a 4-hour trip and it's cheap. It's like $200 to fly to Israel, and you can fly to Egypt, like hotel for a week and your plane ticket for like $400 a person to spend a week in Egypt. We flew to Malta. You can just go so many places. Yes, in America you can drive, But where we live in Michigan, there's not a whole lot. You can go down south. It's about an 8-hour drive. You can get to Gatlinburg, Tennessee, which everybody does because it's like a place to go. You can get to the mountains, the Appalachian Mountains, maybe 8-9 hours. Like if you lived out west in America and you could like get in your car and drive to Mexico, or you could drive to, you know, Utah and the Monument Valley and the Grand Canyon and all that would be great. So here it's kind of like that, except there's even more variety, more places to go. Number 10, the gifts. All the stores are closed right now, so I wish I could just walk in one of these stores. Like there's a store here in this center square that's absolutely beautiful, has so many beautiful gifts. But I love the beautiful Czech pink porcelain, the Bohemian crystal. There's so many beautiful gifts. They don't break the bank. They're not that expensive. You can bring home these gorgeous wine glasses that are painted and have flowers sticking out of them. You can bring home this old ancient green glass and blown glass, and you're literally not going to break the bank. And you can bring all these gifts to all these people. You can use them yourself. The mocha glasses, you can buy these coffee cups that have mocha art on them. I mean, I absolutely love all the gifts that I can buy in this country and use for myself. I don't just buy them as gifts. I drink wine only out of Bohemian crystal. I drink my coffee only out of mocha coffee cups. I mean, I just have gorgeous dishes and vases and paintings on the wall and everything that you can get in this country for such a good price. So there you have it. That's 10 things I absolutely love about living in Czechia. Tak, příští týden. Ciao.